Us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
remember and throw, Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, Hills, O most Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our Lord.
Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages, gentle.
Amen.
Those apostles who were scattered because of the persecution that arose over Stephen, traveled as far as Phoenicia and Cyprus and Antioch, speaking the word to none except Jews. But there were some of the men of Cyprus and Cyrene, who on coming to Antioch spoke to the Greeks also, to the Lord Jesus. And the hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number that believed turned to the Lord. News of this came to the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he came and saw the great crowd, he was glad, and he exhorted them all to remain faithful to the Lord with steadfast purpose, for he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith. And a large company was added to the Lord. So Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year they met with the church and taught a large number of people, and in Antioch the disciples were for the first time called Christians. Now in those days prophets came down from Jerusalem to Antioch, and one of them named Agabus stood up and foretold by the Spirit that there would be a great famine over all the world, and this took place in the days of Claudius. And the disciples determined every one according to his ability to send relief to the brethren who lived in Judea, and they did so, sending it to the elders by the hand of Barnabas and Saul.
I will speak to you, Amon. Just then his disciples came. They marveled that he was talking with a woman, but none said to him, What do you wish? Or why are you talking with her? So the woman left her water jar and went into a city and said to the people, Come, see a man who said to me all that I ever did. Can this be the Christ? They went out of the city and were coming to him. Meanwhile, the disciples besought him, saying, Rabbi, eat. But he said to them, I have food to eat of which you do not know. So the disciples said one to another, Has anyone brought him food? Jesus said to them, My food is to do the will of him who sent me and to accomplish his work. Do you not say there are yet 4 months, then comes the harvest? I tell you, lift up your eyes and see how the fields are already white for harvest. He who reaps wages receives wages and gathers fruit for eternal life, so that sower and reaper may rejoice together. For here are the sayings hold true, one sows and another reaps. I will send you to reap that for which you did not labor. Others have labored, and you have entered into their labor. Many Samaritans from that city believed in him because of the woman's testimony. He said to me, All that I ever did. So when the Samaritans came to him, they asked him to stay with them, and he stayed there 2 days. And many more believed because of his words. They said to those women, It is no longer because of your words that we believe, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this indeed is the Savior of the world.
Glory to thee.
Church called her Fatini. We have a conversation between Christ and not just a Samaritan woman, not even just with a woman named Fatini, but we have a conversation with the Son of God and the very soul of a living human being. Her name, of course, in Greek, is with splendor, with light. And having met the Lord Jesus Christ this day, she's received the living water which he spoke and has indeed changed her into a light that is shining. Eventually, she and her family became martyrs in North Africa. And it's good for us to remember that every saint is offered to us as an example. They're there for us as well. Though we might not be able to emulate the concrete day-by-day life that she lived, which any saint lived, we can't repeat every step they took from earth in their journey to heaven. We can't learn. We can learn a lot from these holy people. And one thing we learn is that by the grace of our living God, we can achieve what seems humanly impossible. We need to give consideration to that. This thing called Christianity is not just a bunch of good, sterling citizens going out and maybe just doing some sterling things, good citizens, but it's a heavenly life that's lived in this world, a life that is more than just human life, but it's a life that's clothed with Jesus Christ, on people, hopefully like ourselves. We want to be in that image and likeness. To be in this world. A world of darkness. And a world of tragedy. Which is in the power of our eyes. That we can become a word of truth. That something that is essentially impossible becomes possible because of this living water and because of this light that He fills us with. We can become a sign of hope and the certainty that God can conquer and bring this hope if we only allow Him access to our souls. And this is what's taking place. It's a conversation with your soul. And He has conversation with our souls as well. If indeed we allow Him access. Because if the kingdom of God is not established within us, if God is not enthroned in our minds and in our hearts, a fire that destroys everything unworthy of ourselves and of Him, we cannot offer God's light, and we cannot offer living water at best, just empty words, and just plain old water, which just isn't good enough. It isn't what our Lord has in mind. And today's woman, this Samaritan, this Fotini, Saint Fotini, speaks of such as Christ has said that He is the light. He's the light of the world. The light that enlightens all men, that He alone gives living water to very, very thirsty souls. And we, my brothers and sisters in Christ, are called to give shelter within our souls and within our minds and within our hearts, indeed within our whole being, to this light and to be urns of this water, so that the word spoken by Christ, let your light so shine before all men, that seeing your good deeds, they may give glory to your Father who is in heaven, and may be fulfilled and accomplished in and through us. Because it is only through seeing our deeds and through seeing how we live that people can believe. And once again, not just light, and not just sparkless water, but heavenly light and living water is to be ours to carry and to deliver, to touch every human being that we come in contact with. The light is God's light, and the water is God's world. That makes it different. Just like we pray before baptism for the water, we pray 3 times. And when we're done, that's just not ordinary water anymore. That's living water. And it's not in our words as we live out our lives, unless they are words of truth and of power. It's just so much hockey, just so much stuff. Every human being, every one of us needs the warmth of this light. Every human being needs the compassion refreshment of this living water. No matter how together we think we have it, no matter how well we can craft some idea, it doesn't matter. We're all still trying to figure out how we're going to get home in one piece every night, right? We're all sort of a mess. We just don't want to talk about it. Starting in the household of the faith, the community of Christ, there's a lot of need. It's a good place to practice. It's a good place to get it together. There are burdens that we carry. There's need of encouragement. There is need to be lifted up. And there is need to help us remember Jesus Christ. You know how it is. There is need to remember as well that life is very short and we must redeem the time. I had a good friend at one of our officers, just a great guy. He's about 33, 34 years old. Ricky Nilos is Greek. He's Orthodox. Three little boys, healthy as anything. He was a great officer. About 3 or so weeks ago, didn't feel too good. Went to bed, crawled into bed. One of his son, I think, slept on the floor that night. Next morning, Nicky was dead. Ricky was dead. He was dead. They had to run an autopsy on him. I thought, my gosh, he was as healthy as you could be. But you know, God said, hey, that's it. It's time. My point is, we have no idea. We have no idea. Redeem the time. We have a very young congregation. I thought being young was pretty cool, actually. It's looking better all the time. I wasted a lot of time. I wasted a lot of words. But my friends, listen. Life is short. Don't put it off. Don't put it off. Making your soul available to that conversation with Jesus Christ. Too often, our words are careless. We're clever. I oftentimes hear somebody say, oh, he's very intelligent. You know, I think, who cares? I've met a lot of intelligent people. I've been many places in this world. Give me a wise man. Give me a man of discernment. Give me a gentle soul with wisdom. And that's good enough. We're clever. We're intelligent. We have hobby horses, clever ideas we like to entertain ourselves with, but usually not very edifying. And as the saying goes, just because we have a thought doesn't mean we need to share it. In fact, there's many thoughts we have, many clever, intelligent ideas we have that need to be buried. They need to die. And move to those things that can edify. Move to those things that can help move somebody else, including yourselves, more toward eternity. Give words, give deeds that lift up, give warmth of the light of Christ, and begin to satisfy the thirst that might be in someone else. On Friday, I had to go to the doctor. I have a vascular disease in my legs, and that's why I didn't count on my knees. Easy, I'm walking. The man who is my doctor, I began going to him in December, he's Egyptian. Egyptian Christian. So I said, well, back in December, are you a Coptic? He said, no. And he said, no, we're even a smaller percentage. He said, I'm a Protestant, evangelical Christian from Egypt. He said, there aren't many of us left. Okay. So I went to see him again for another appointment on Friday. And I went in. And of course, the usual doctor question, how are you? I always laughed at myself. I mean, if I was doing well, I wouldn't be here. But I looked at him, he asked, and I thought, well, I knew him to be a very spiritual man at this point, some 6 months after having met him. How am I? So I told him, not so good. He said, not so good. I said, please, pray for my wife. And I explained why I asked him to pray for my wife. I said, I believe that you're a man of prayer, and I'd like you to pray, please. What's your name? I told him my wife's name. So there in his office, he said, well, let's pray right now. Okay. And so we bowed our heads and he prayed. And his little office, the exam room, was filled with just the greatest light. The greatest light. It was filled with grace. And it was filled with living water. And as he prayed his most eloquent prayer, I provided more water. It's about all I do these days. As my tears dripped literally on the floor, he prayed and prayed. It was such a compassionate, just special moment. This man had prepared himself to be a conveyor of light and water, the water, the living water of Jesus Christ. I was the person that needed it. And when he finished, he said, please, please let me know. Just include me. So I left. I went out. Deacon Rick had taken me. Day. And I said to him, I said, you know, the scriptures remind us that sometimes we entertain angels unawares. And I said, I don't want to miss any angels. And that's why I asked. You know, that's why I wanted his prayers. And I cannot tell you just what an experience it was and how I thought of this scripture for today, and what we all have an opportunity to share, to be ready to share. He had no idea what his day was going to hold, and I had no idea what mine was going to hold. Last night, I was sharing this with Mr. Gonzalez. I think his first name is Christian, and the man who talked about money management, whatever. I hope I got it right. And he said, Father, I've heard said that our tears are from the Mother of God, and they're her compassion for those who are suffering. Listen, we've got to help. We've got to do our part, and may God bless us and ask for the prayers of St. Fotini, that we too might enter into that conversation with Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
kingdom, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, the Lord God, remember him in thy kingdom, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Caitlin, for Michelle, Claire, and Kelsey, may the Lord our God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For the Orthodox servants of God who parted this life, Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Peace and repentance, amen.
Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, so, Lord.
Following your number and sorrow, Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, we give the Savior. All the saints, let us commit ourselves to each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Non-existence into being, and when we have fallen away, his praises begin, and it's not. not cease to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven and hast endowed us with thy kingdom, which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee, to thy only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. For all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands. Even though there stand beside these thousands of archangels and the thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many eyes soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
Thank you.
holy churches in peace, save thee, honor, health, and length of days, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth.
Amen.
let us attend.
Holy things are for the holy.
Thank you.
of those who might be visiting an Orthodox church for the first time, welcome to St. Barnabas. I do want to take this occasion to remind you, though, that the meeting we're about to serve is only for chrismated members of the Eastern Orthodox Church.
With the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Thank you.
and bless thine inheritance.
Name of the Lord, and so
Peter said, she was of his own back, and he overcame this holy mother. By the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable, by those powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable, Lord's prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of all the glorious and victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of St. Barnabas, the patron protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy and glorious great martyr of Tini, the Samaritan woman, of the martyr Isidore of Chios, higher martyr of Theophon, the bishop of Cyprus, the new martyrs John of Bulgaria, and Mark of Crete, and the venerable Isidore of Moscow, full for Christ, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind, Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon us in the tomb. Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
Christos Anesti.
Christos Anesti.
Christos Enviat.
Enviat Enviat.
Agnus Dei
Come.
Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
Sometimes get nervous, they become, here we go, the big head. They either want me to go to Africa or they want me to help. Okay, well, you can do both, okay? You can go to Africa, you can help. But Nathan Hoppe will be here to speak to us on the incarnational faith and salvation of the world. It's really not to be missed. He's a very, very gifted speaker, and it'll be worth your while. And really looking for your salvation to hear and get his help. June 11th, Chili Cook-Off. You know what that's all about. The last weekend in June, can't remember the actual date, but it's the last full weekend, we have the first ever ordinations for on Saturday, or the Deacon John Valadez to the Holy Priesthood, and on Sunday the next day, Deacon Andrew Honore to the Holy Priesthood. And so please plan ahead. Those will be very crowded days. So, come on. Also, that will be the bishop, presiding bishop that day will be His Grace Bishop Nicholas, who is out of headquarters in Englewood. Also, we want to help them get their first set of vestments. And Armin, maybe you can say a word about that.
Vestments are not cheap. And they're going to be graduating, becoming priests. Well, not graduating, they're going to become priests first, ordained. And we want to bless them by giving them a gift of a set of vestments at the cost of $500 each. So, if you are willing and able to contribute to that, we're going to be taking up a collection. You can drop a check in the offering box back here, or give sell a check or cash. And if you think about it, if 40 of us contribute $25 each, then we're home free. So thank you for considering that.
And one last thing. Got a message yesterday from Staff Sergeant Peter Wilson. After 8 months in the beautiful country of Afghanistan, he sent us an email from Qatar. They're on their way home.
Amen.
They go from there to, look, military transport does not make a straight line anymore. Okay? When they went 8 months ago to Afghanistan, they started in Texas, went to Maine, went to Greenland or Iceland, Ireland, England, Germany, and finally they found their way to Afghanistan. They dropped things off on the way, sort of like UPS. So, they're on their way home, but if you want to know exactly when they're getting here, I don't know what the phone number is for the Department of Defense. Feel free to call and ask. Because I have no idea, okay? If you see him walk in, he's here. But he's on the way. And the great thing is, they're on planes that are a lot safer than Delta, Continental, American, United. Because they're on a plane filled with Special Forces guys who really want to get home. So you got a plane full of soldiers who they'll keep order among themselves. There'll be nobody pulling them off the plane, I tell you that right. So anyway, thank God. It was a great Mother's Day present for Lynn yesterday, and a really wonderful present to Alex, who's with Karina this morning. She didn't want her to be alone. Thank God.
Never end to be just all the years.